So again, you take a chance to find a space where you don't need to move. Has anyone not been on a gong journey before?
First time with you, for me.
But you've been on Adeline. That's fine. Thank you, sir. These instruments move a lot of energy. If they encounter blockages in your body, sometimes you'll get muscle twitches or little places where you'll feel stressed. Breath is your friend there. Nothing that we're going to do here is going to harm you, but if the energy starts moving through you and it hits blockages, it may feel a little uncomfortable. So just be aware of that. Again, my favorite analogy is like, I want to be culturally sensitive, let's see. Middle Earth type dwarves carving with their pickaxes, breaking up blockages. That's what works well for me.
Right.
But anything that helps you visualize the energy flowing through and breaking out any blockages will help ease that. And if it gets too much, you can always step out on the back of an eye under the couch there. It's a little bit quieter. You won't have any trouble with that, won't you? There is a cat in the room. So if you feel something gliding over you, it's Bossed, and you've been blessed by Bossed. I don't know exactly how long we're going to go. Probably not more than an hour, because it is late. Moves a lot of energy. So there will be variations in volume. When it gets quiet, the invitation is to follow your breath, do your journey. I will call you back verbally when we're finished. So until then, just use whatever time and space is for your meditation and your movement of energy, and don't worry about when we're coming back. I'm bringing you home safe, I promise. I miss you, Ka'imila. I always like to take a few breaths, slow and deep into my belly, slowly filling my entire thoracic cavity entrance to the top of my lungs. Easy and comfortable, not a ton of stress. Hold at the top for 2 or 3 seconds, and then just as slowly and completely releasing. And I will even bring my belly button back towards my spine, really clear out in the air. Hold for count of 2 or 3, and then repeat that process. And while I do that, I like to grow roots. Mom and Guy is here. I'm sure there's a mycelium mat underneath us. We're going to create one for sure. That gives you an opportunity to have a place for any energies that do get moved that you're finished with, to allow them to release and give them a nice safe place to go. I'll even put a deep root down straight from my butt all the way into the center of the earth. So just energy being illuminated goes straight into Mom and Gaia, because she knows how to deal with it, and she will transmute it. Might even send some back up through those same root structures. Might be useful for you. I hope you have a pleasant journey.
Thank you.
Thank you. As the sound journey draws to a close, these vibrations swim off into the ether, the invitation is to find your breath. Change it, just notice where it is. And allow that noticing to gently, gracefully guide you back in. Gentle reminder that your beautiful spirit inhabits a beautiful physical structure that's treating you so well. You may notice as your awareness
gently glides back into your body. It might be ready for a little movement. Maybe nothing extreme, just a pinky curl. And your toes wanting to stretch out a little bit. I invite you to marvel at how wonderfully well your body responds to those requests for movement. To appreciate all the intricacy that goes into extending the left index finger. We are magnificent. And so as your body calls for more and more movement, stretching a little bit, shrugging your shoulders more, shifting your hips. Invite you into a state of gratitude. And there is no hurry, but eventually you may find yourself called to open your eyes, take a deeper breath, or maybe you notice that you're a little thirsty and it's time for some water. Been trying on the concept of calling this state yummy-licious Ananda. Not sure if it's going to stick. But I like the way it feels. We didn't actually live stream this one, but we are recording it for remix and put out later. So had we done the regular Facebook thing, I'd be bidding you all adieu. With a reminder to drink plenty of water over the next 3 days. Sometimes these vibrations can release toxins. And it's really good to hydrate well so that they don't decide to land elsewhere. They get flushed out really well. More than adequate hydration is good for you every now and then anyway. And they tell me that 90% of the United States population that does have access to good clean water is not hydrated enough for health. So drink more. Drink more now. And certainly if you're going to get behind the wheel of a car, get your feet on the ground, drink some water, make sure you feel really back in your body. Welcome yourself home. Hug somebody. That's always a good plan. Mm-hmm. Feels good too. Thanks so much for sticking around this late.